What's up, guys and gals? My name is Splattercat, and we're here again today, still on the planet Meridian. The planet Meridian has turned into a quagmire, but anyways, let's talk about what we want to do in this episode. So we can either fight some orcs, or we can get down and find some more prime gene samples. So I think that's what we're going to do. Let's jump off planet really quickly, and I think Calderas had both. Let's go to Calderas, and we're going to handle the infestation here. We've got two bonus deployments anyway, so Tingle Gate. This is like the gate of ASMR, or that's like full body ASMR for Space Marines. It's the only way they get by with their purple tingles. God. All right, so we have the Killer Serpent, or we have the Hand of the Hive Mind. Well, better the hand than the balls, I guess. Let's go for the hand. And we're going to bring, what level is Thaddeus? He's level 9. We've got to keep bringing him along. Let's even his level out a tad. I think I'm going to keep my squad as it stands right now. Leave Cyrus out for a little bit. I like Cyrus a lot. He's really good for scouting. He's really good for killing the big guys. But since we don't have any Melta support going on, I guess I'll just bring, yeah, let's just bring Thaddeus and we'll do the Hand of the Hive Mind.
Commander, orbital sensors have located a powerful Tyranid target. This creature of the Zoanthrope genus exists to channel the psychic might of the Hive Mind. Victory here will help us on all fronts, Commander. We will push the infesting swarm back a step, gaining us precious time. We will also gain valuable information that could help us locate a primary hive.
Then let it be so. Deploy. I always feel like they speak with too much gusto. They're like, rah. I am Gabriel Angelos. Like, he's always, you know, it seems like they're putting too much formality into it. Maybe it's just me. But I guess they're kind of formal guys. They like to show up. They only wear tuxedos outside of the suits. I don't know if you guys knew that or not. Let's deploy in. Lovely. I need a pet Zoanthrope. That's what I need. Better a pet Carnifex. I'd never have to turn in homework again. And then I could make YouTube videos all day every day for you guys. School would never get in the way.
What may. This beast must die today.
We know the stakes, Tarkus. The time for proclamations is long past.
Let's push. We're gonna use the tackies as scouts and tanks for a little bit here. And to avoid what happened in the last time we had a Tyranid infestation, I am terrified that they're going to try and jump me, like, straight out of the gate here. I always get nervous. Let's grab the supplies we can for now.
Hostiles.
Yep, there they are. Let's get into a building, if we can. Get the Force Commander in there to pick a fight. Ooh, I forgot to give him the upgraded backpack. That's what I forgot. Okay, so we can jump into here, but I don't know what's coming. Let's go ahead and send the Force Commander in first. And then these guys can jump in, and then we'll bring in the tackies. Let's clear them out of the building really quickly. And we'll have them set up there. With the best intent being, what is, oh, is that the Zoanthrope right there? We'll kill it. Smack it in the face, repeatedly. We might consider throwing a grenade down in here. Assault squad's pretty beat up already. Oh, Force Commander's down. Okay. Seems like a typical Tyranid mission. Let's have, yeah, we're just gonna have to run around in circles now, so they're doing exactly what I was hoping they would not do. I don't think I can knock the Carnifex back with a jump. Let's deploy a tarantula, just to say we did. The building's not taking a ton of damage, so we should be able to clear the enemies before it blows up. Yeah, it looks like they're not even able to. The Carnifex doesn't appear to be a siege engine, so that's fine. Let's wipe him out really quickly, and then we'll recover as best we can. Force Commander's down there bleeding out, just all kinds of rectal bleeding occurring. I miss Cyrus already. Brothers, fire. Grab that really quickly, and then we'll have them respawn while we wait. More enemies coming along. The Tarantula and the remainder of our troops should be able to handle that no problem. They can't make that shot right there, unfortunately. Let's go ahead and have everybody jump back into combat. I definitely think Thaddeus needs more HP before he's going to be useful to me. Let's think about getting Tarkus in here somewhere. Assault squad to take that guy out if they can. There it is. Just bowl him over if they can. And then we'll get a res going while these guys are fighting them off at a range. You guys out of the building and get down here and set up too. What is that? Another Zoanthrope? Damn it. Get back in the building. It's going to eat you. It's going to cheat you like lovely Linguini. Linguini flavored like Space Marine. And then let's do another jump, see if we can blow them up a tad. Very good. A little bit more death and another superior plating. Lots of superior platings going around right now. God, 30 seconds in, we've already lost a unit. And it's completely and totally my fault. I don't know what to do with assault units, like ever. We don't need to go down this way. This location is looking mighty fine already, unless we really need, like, emergency supplies. Let's move them forward. We'll jump him in and wipe them out as we can. Thaddeus will grab that position. Now that they're out of their entrenched, dug-in position, we'll go down here. And I think what we'll do is we'll clear out this outer ring, we'll grab that CP, and once we get all the CPs nice and under our control, we should be okay. Let's use the Force Commander as bait for just a moment, because he can teleport out if he needs to. Assault squad, prepare for combat. Oh, there it is right there. Okay, so we've got more guys coming in. Let's teleport the Commander in right there. It looks like we got a pretty good feeling about where the remainder of the units are. There's another Zoanthrope down there. Tyranids are probing us a little bit, just getting their finger in there and wiggling a tad. Wipe those guys out, retreat them back out. They should be able to hold on this front, no problem. I think you just jump them in, and that's pretty much all they're good for, is you just jump them in, and then once they're jumped, they're pretty much worthless. I don't know. It seems like if they can one-shot the little units, they're okay, but if you put them in any type of sustained combat, they just seem to get their they get their asses kicked. Ooh, there's a nice little explosion. I'm going to transition the Tactical Marines off to the right. And let's wait and see if we can... The Gift of Maz. We'll pick that up really quickly. Let's get our Assault Marines into a better position and maybe... Ooh! The Blighted Bolter. And also some more Dreadnought plating. There is a lot of Dreadnought plating going around. Thaddeus, get back into cover. These guys are just running back and forth. They just don't know what they want. There we go. So now that we're all nice and settled... Well, they're still behind us. I guess not completely settled. What are you doing, Tarkus? Fire at the guys coming up the stairs. Just being oblivious. The spirit of the derpy wolf is with him. Okay. Let's take the Force Commander. And I'm actually going to walk him into here. Oh my. Lots of enemies to think about. So let's get them forward. And we're going to jump in and see if we can stomp these guys down just a tad before we retreat them back out. Force Commander is going to need to help over here, I think. Let's put him into Merciless Strike mode. I don't know exactly how that works, but we'll jump him out if he needs to. Yeah, we'll jump him out, put the Force Commander back in, just kind of do a little bit of wiggling here. God. And I did this to myself, too. I had a feeling they were going to press really, really hard the moment I walked over here. Luckily, let's get Avitus in there. Let's make a unified front if we can. Teleport the Force Commander in. They're spawning from this pool down here. Okay, well, let's push for the field down here then. We don't need to hold this, but since they're spawning down here, that's something to think about. I'm gonna teleport the Force Commander in, and let's just raise hell down here if we can. Tactical Marines, let's see if we can get them into any decent position. I need Avitus out of there so we can call in an artillery strike down here if this doesn't work out in our favor. He's doing a pretty good job of injuring things and causing pain, but let's port him back out. And while Avitus is here, let's drop an artillery strike right there. And then we're gonna pull him back. Tacky's up front. Avitus fall back. Force Commander right there. And assault dive right now. And there it is. Very, very good. Let's draw them all back. Force Commander stay up front. Grab the loot. I'm having trouble deciding on a beachhead here that I want to take. I do need that building to go away. It should melt. It's got 1 HP, really. What are the chances of us landing on 1 HP with that thing? Force Commander, get in there. Tactical Marines, you're right there. Avitus, you're right there. Keep the Assault Marines in the back, but accessible, so at any moment I can drop them in for a nice little sneak attack. In fact, I smell one right now. Let's get in there. Oh my god, there's a lot of them. Get him down in there. Assault Marines, fall back. Kind of bait them into your position if you can. Hey, Tactical Marines, cover these guys while they escape. Come on, Tackies, you can do it. Force Commander's down here just like leveling people. Oh my. And it's time. Ooh, what a kill. That was good. That was real good. I liked that. That was pleasurable on all fronts. Like a tickle in the tummy. No. Like a tickle in the tummy. Always pleasurable. You guys handling things over here? Alright, good. That's what I like to see. Oh, there's another spawning pool right there, so we're gonna have to actually take measures. I'm gonna jump into this position right here, maybe wipe out. There we go. I need to take that position. And then consider going down here. Let's port the commander in just to draw fire. Tackies can set up there. Avitus can set up there, although he's not gonna have line of sight on a lot of the shots. Oh, they're coming up behind me again. God, there are just so many. Thaddeus, we need help down here. There we go. So that clears them out. Keep our Devastators from being isolated from behind. Force Commander's looking a little beat up, so let's give him a tad of a bit of love. Let's move Avitus forward. Maybe think about doing some sneakery. Yeah, we need to jump in, like, right here. And now that they're suppressed, we fall on back with the cover from Avitus, who is now going to go into focus fire. And they have no cover, so they should go down pretty quickly. I think my tackies just hung tight during that whole thing. I don't even think I really used them that well. It's okay, though. Now we've got a position that we can actually control. So this should work. Yeah, the numbers are endless, no kidding. Okay, so this spawning ground is completely wiped out. Let me send Tarkus over here to grab the supplies. The problem with this mission is I would very much like to grab that communications array, but since it can spawn like endless enemies, that means I'm always going to be pincered the entire game. I do want to push to the right, though, and try and take that communications. I really do. There's no sense not taking it, basically. Brothers. Let's have them run over here and maybe take this CP, so at least something's happening right now. They seem to be fighting for this position from Tormagaunts and Hormagaunts non-stop. Okay, let's fall back now, so maybe we'll stop aggroing them. We've taken at least enough, a little bit of a dent out of them right there. We've got a new location. Let's think about taking this CP coming around. Engage jump packs. It is done. Move on. Yeah, they're just gonna keep peppering me. It's like non-stop hectoring, basically. Come on, aliens. Pyramid assault. Yeah, it's pretty much endless. Orc Crusher and Orc Killer. We've got the whole set. Although presumably one leads to the other. Alright, anything else coming at us? Let's continue that little march backwards to try and take this position over here, swing all the way around, and then take the communications array before anything else goes wrong. Another group of Termagaunts. Why do you hate me, Nids? You should love me. I should be like a Hershey bar to you. Just nice and tasty. Like a big old bag of bloody Skittles. Let's wipe that thing out while we're here. It's still firing at the building that my Devastators were in. In fact, let's position the Devastators, just in case. And let's get the Force Commander and everybody else into a position that's going to be beneficial. Let's have them wipe this thing out, actually. I don't know why it's still shooting that building. Must really want to wipe out Tatooine or whatever the hell planet we're on, Calteris. Let's have the Tackies capture that right now, although that's probably not the best thing to task them with. They seem to be better used at other things. Avidus should be able to hold that right there, no problem. Yeah. It'll be okay. I could use tarantulas to make beachheads, but I prefer to save them. It's a tough call, actually. Let's do it. Let's use tarantulas to make beachheads here so that I can move around without any horrible things happening to me. Something at least to just slow them down on all these fronts. Drop another one right there in case. I mean, I know these aren't the end-all be-all, but at least they buy me some time to take this communications array. Tarkus reporting. Destination confirmed. Ready to bug with it. This is Thaddeus. We have our orders. Send the tank out in front. Ah, there we go. I was wondering if there was going to be some kind of sneakily snuck attack. Make short work of them. Move the tackies up with Avitus in the back. We'll bring them on back in. Force Commander's up here tanking already. Oh, we've got spore mines. Want to be very careful about our assault attacks if we've got spore mines around. Force Commander, get out of there. At least until the spore mines are taken care of. And let's get going making ourselves a beachhead. Actually, it looks like there's not going to be a whole lot of resistance here. Let's get the tackies in. And then we'll get Avidus down here. Assault squad, get down here and maybe flush them out. As soon as you're in range, that's what I would like to see. And Force Commander's just standing there like a dunce right now. Very good. Don't go in any further. Capture the building and then we'll wipe out the rest of these. This mission's going pretty well, aside from the really shaky start. Whatever that first assault from Tyranids is just really, really overwhelming. And they always try and pull it off, too, and it's always bolstered by, like, a Carnifex every single time. Luckily, I'm getting a little bit ready for it at this point, so it's not quite so terrifying when it happens, but still. That last time, I lost a good unit right there, which means we lose our resilience score. Field generators are deploying now, Commander. Very good. Sehr gut. Ooh, a very nice jump. I actually didn't even plan that one. It just kind of happened nicely. This does sort of raise the question, like, can you sit here and just farm XP off these guys? We need to take an advanced position, so let's go ahead and have the Force Commander Yeah, jump square into their territory, and we'll put him on this little mortar launcher for now. A superior missile launcher nestled between the building. I can rotate, but I don't want to give you guys motion sickness or anything. We'll move the tactical marines up for the time being so that at least they're in a position where they can contribute to the fight somehow. And there goes the little hive sphincter. It's all taken out. I'm going to move Avidus up and take this building. I don't know if this will affect this thing, but maybe it will. Nope. Well, they can just attack it then. There's not a lot of enemies here. Good, 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 good. So we're all taken care of there. We may want to do a central sweep through here. Just see what there is on offer in terms of a fight. Because you don't want to leave XP behind if you can help it. Avidus is stuck in a building. Let's move Avidus forward. There we go. Let's get him into combat, put him into battle mode. Start chucking grenades if we can. Grenade didn't really help, but it's something. What is that? Another lictor. Okay. Lictors tend to drop loot, which makes me happy about fighting lictors. I don't actually hate fighting them. Let's bring the assault squad down so that they're accessible for now. Put him into focus fire mode. Let's call in a mortar. Why not? Let's see how much damage we can deal with this mortar. We're about to wrap this thing up anyways. Could the mortar have probably been used elsewhere better? Probably. But I wanted to make some sense. I wanted to see something burn. My inner space marine. My inner angry marine got the best hold of me.
I can feel the thing scratching at my mind.
Steal yourselves and advance.
Cyrus isn't here. Cyrus is oddly omnipresent. We need to make better use of Cyrus if he's able to just, like, show up places. Let's teleport in, deal some damage there. Tactical squad. Not a lot of positions that I like for my tactical squad right now. Maybe, like, right there if they can press the assault. Might be worth, yeah, let's get rid of some of these little mortary things over here. You guys can take shots at that. And also shoot at the Zoanthrope. Ooh. Okay, Zoanthrope needs to go now. Alright, so focus fire on the Zoanthrope. I remember Zoanthropes now. Get out of there, tackies. Let's see if maybe we can disable it with a jump here before it does any further damage. Ooh, it is just not stopping its focus fire. That's worrisome. It's a tough little bastard. I'll give it that. Let's drop a medkit early rather than later. There we go. Looks like we got a Terminator cannon over there. Let's fall back for just a moment. What are they shooting at? Why are they shooting at the... Oh, it's because... Ah, they're imploding. Okay. That thing was nasty. I thought it was just a normal Zoanthrope. I didn't realize it was one of the toughies. Let's get everybody into a position where they can actually injure something. Because that's where Space Marines like to be. Right next to things, injuring them. Horrifically. Let's help with this base for now. Looks like we got another... Synaptic, is that a... No, that's a brood nest. Okay, I've got to kill these. Let's maybe think about having them clear out some of these units over here. While these guys kill this. We'll wipe out this building just to get a better score. Mortar strike the hell out of that thing. There we go. With a single synaptic generator left, we will strongly consider... I know, I'm getting lazy right now. If you're sitting there going like, what are you doing? Why aren't you like jump striking people? I know, I'm being lazy. I'm being super lazy right now. Let's go ahead and have our remaining ranged units wipe those guys out. The glory of Mateel. And there it is. So that's another mission down.
The Tyranids are attacking.
None can stop the crusade.
Sehr gut. Very nice. Happy with that result. Take a look. We got a generic power fist. Might be nice to slap onto somebody else down the line. Fury, 97%, not too bad. Speed, a little slow because I got bogged down. It's okay, though. There's no additional deployments on the books right now, so there's nothing really to work towards. Everybody leveled up. That's nice. And we got a Blighted Bolter, which is badass. It's got reduced range, which is a little bit of a downer. Means I probably won't end up using it because range is fairly key. If you can outrange somebody, you pretty much win. Then again, it might force me to kind of play a shoot-and-scoot battle. So it might be a good thing. It might be a reinforcing pit.
A great victory, Commander. Our librarians report the High Fleet shuddered and screamed when you dealt the killing blow. And we are even closer to obtaining the biotoxin we need to execute our plan of attack.
This zoanthrope was frustratingly close to giving us a pure genetic sample, but it has undergone small mutations. We did gather valuable data, though, and we are getting close to isolating the primary hive's genetic template.
Why must we find a primary hive?
Tyranids mutate rapidly, Sergeant. This is what makes them such deadly opponents. They are constantly evolving to counter our weaponry. A primary hive contains the original genetic template for a hive fleet. If you can find that, you can predict several generations of mutations.
Yes, finding a primary hive will allow us to develop a poison that will kill all Tyranid variants quickly. They will not have time to adapt to resistance.
Okay, so let's do our level ups and look at some of the gear. Here with our Force Commander, let's keep moving him towards his No Mercy, No Respite. Let's jump over there. He hit level 12. That's going to leave him with some options for new kit. Let's see if there's anything higher level around that I like. Not really. Unfortunate. There is a ranged damage boost, though, so the Gift of Mars might be nice on somebody. The 3 melee skill, that might be well served on Thaddeus, assuming he levels up enough, which he did not. I don't know if we want to give him the Berserker mode, but I feel like he gets killed really quickly, so maybe some more HP will help him. Yeah, that temporarily invulnerable, that Aegis of Fury, would be really nice. We can also give him a Power Fist. Let's see if that actually ends up being better. It doesn't, actually. Okay. So he dropped from 160 damage down to like 114 with that. I was wondering how the percentages would play into it. And if he levels up one more time, we can give him much, much better abilities. That's going to lower his accuracy. That's a pretty nice one, though, too. But I'm going to sacrifice it. Let's sacrifice it and do what we got to do. Get rid of the plating. There's another plating. Wisdom's Boon. A Relic Bolter. We'll get rid of that. The Manifest Death. It's a pretty badass name for a gun. Relic Chainsword. We'll get rid of... Actually, is that... What kind of respect is that better in? 50 damage? It's a lot better in terms of DPS, so I might consider holding onto that until he levels so that we have a backup item. Get rid of that terrible Power Fist. Blighted Armor. He can equip it, strangely enough. Yeah, I don't know. I was hoping it wasn't, like, cursed or anything. That would suck. For our Force Commander, let's give him the better Soaring Truth. There we are. Oh, never mind. That's a jump pack. I don't know if I want the jump pack versus the teleport pack. The teleport pack makes him really mobile. I think I'm going to stick with the teleport pack for now. Let's take a look at Tarkus. Keep working him towards veteran squad mates. And he's probably going to be able to equip something nice right here. Argentus Fury. No, we don't really want that. We already used that. We'll get rid of it and we'll save him for a little bit later. Possibly equipping him with the Blighted Bolter. Avitus. Avitus is still using a reasonably low-level weapon for what he's doing. Let's finish off our goal down here. So he's got Battle Lust. He can now get energy back every time he kills somebody. That's going to help him maintain focus fire. Let's see here. Anything else that I want to slap on him? And give him better range damage and better movement speed. That'll work out. Let's do that. So he's going to move a little bit quicker, and he's going to do way more range damage. He's up to 340, which is just mind-blowing. Everybody else is pretty much in a good position for as far as their gear goes, so I think what I'll do is I'll break it off here. My name is Splattercat, thank you for joining me here at the Nerd Castle for another adventure in Dawn of War. Jumping over to Calderas, I hope to see you guys next time. There are big things in the future for the Nerd Castle, and I'll try and do an official announcement pretty soon. I'll see you guys next time. Take care out there, everybody.